إن الحمد لله نحمد ونستعين ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah, and whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen, and I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The words of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Al-Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Al-Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Al-Islam. Inshallah, Tuesday, that as usual, that we have the Tawheed or the Aqeedah class. And as we stated before, many times the Aqeedah, the belief, is our foundation. As a result of this, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't accept any good deed unless that we have the proper Aqeedah, the proper understanding and the proper belief concerning the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the rest of the articles of belief. And we had stated last week that one of the worldly benefit of Tawheed, that it will unite the Muslims. Because of the people have their own understanding and their own ideas about who is God or what God supposed to be, everybody have his own idea. So this way we be creating many gods, because everybody have his own feeling and his own estimation and all his own way of feeling. But when we come to Tawheed, the oneness of Allah, and to believe in Allah as Allah told us in Quran, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had informed us in the authentic Sunnah, this what is going to unite us. This was going to bring the people together. Otherwise, will be a confusion, be disagreements, and will be always dispute. Why? Because the people did not come to realization that believing in Allah means to accept what He told us about Himself and what His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about Him. So it is very important that we try to establish Tawheed in our life, because this is the only way we can be united, and also this is the only way that our good deed can be acceptable by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nevertheless, as you see some people support and follow the Tawheed, you will find also people who are enemy of the Tawheed. Okay? So, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had told us, and this is reality, you can see it yesterday, today, and it always going to be there, that you found people always against Tawheed. They would like to have no God, or they have different gods, or everybody make his own gods. But when you come to tell them this is what Allah said, this is what the Prophet said, you will find the animosity and the problems. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had told us in the Quran, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍّ عَدُوًّا شَيَاطِينَ الْإِنسِ وَالْجِنِّ يُوحِي بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَى بَعْضٍ زُخْرُفَ الْقَوْلِ غُرُورًا. In this surah, cattle, al-an'am, that Allah said, indeed we had made for every prophet enemy. Every prophet had came, he found enemy, and the enemy exists or consists of shayateen, from mankind and jinn. Okay? Because shaitan can be a human being and shaitan can be a jinn. Because the Arabic word from shata, which shaitan comes from, that means to go a distance, far away from the truth. Okay? So you will find the shaitan, which is the jinn, shaitan. You found the insi, shaitan, human being. As a result of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say what? Min al jinnati wal nas. Okay? Min al jinnati wal nas. So for every prophet we made a enemy from human being and jinn, which is revealed to one another, communicate to one another, zukhruf al-qawli ghurura, the decoration, decorating the words, philosophy, ideology, a way how to dialogue or debate and win the point with you, okay? And the shayateen will assist the mankind, alright? For what purpose, okay? So they can argue and debate with you about God, okay? Mother Nature, okay? Nobody created me, I created myself, you understand? Things like this. So if the prophets themselves, they have enemies, they were in their way, how you can imagine about us today? About the imams, or the teachers, or the preachers, or the scholars, the Muslims, that they try to teach the people Tawheed. If the Prophet, they face these problems, can you imagine, you understand, that for us today, try to teach the Tawheed. So it is the hikmah and the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He made this to happen, that to be always raised enemies for the people who invite into Tawheed from the shayateen of jinn. To misguide the people and also to try to keep them away from the Tawheed. The Tawheed, how we know the proper Tawheed is what the Prophets taught. Okay? Anything the Prophet taught about Allah, about the Day of Judgment, about the angels, all these things, this is the proper Tawheed, okay? Other than what the Prophet taught could not be Tawheed. The religion and the deen is what the Prophet taught. What the Prophet didn't teach could not be deen, okay? Even if it sounds good to some people, okay? Some of the people, they look to the Tawheed to be a means of disuniting the people, making the people groups, and being against each other. But in actuality, the Tawheed talks about unity. Okay? The Tawheed bring about unity to make everything comes into one. So bring all this ideology and all the thoughts and all the idea to one. Which one? The one that been taught by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Some of the mushrikeen, the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they acknowledge the Tawheed of al-Rububiyyah, the oneness of Lordship. That means they acknowledge existence of God. They acknowledge that God is the creator and the provider. Okay? We call this Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Okay? Oneness of God or oneness of Lordship. But they did not acknowledge the Tawheed of Uluhiyyah, deityship. Okay? That means acknowledge that God exists, He's the one give life and cause death. But they did not acknowledge that no one's supposed to be worshipped other than Allah. As a result of this, they call on their idols. Okay? They worship images, statues, okay, different things like this. So it is big mistake that some people think the Prophet came to tell the people that there is no God, okay, exist, but or that God is the creator. People know that God is the creator. Those people, the Prophet came to them, they know that Allah is the creator of the heaven and the earth. Okay? Even they call him Allah. And the Quran said, وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. If you ask them, Muhammad, who created the heaven and the earth, he will say Allah. So they know that Allah exists. But what was the problem? What was the problem? That they worship Allah and others beside Allah. Okay? They worship others, believing that they will be mediator between them and the Allah. They worship others because they think that this will bring them closer to Allah. And this kind of tawheed they have, it didn't free them from shirk and didn't free them from being kuffar. This is something very important. Alright? So whosoever among them died, he died in a state of kufr. And have no place except the hellfire. Okay? They did not abandon their gods or their deities, although they exist, they believe that Allah exists. And their argument, as the Quran telling us in Surah Sad, أَجَعَلَ الْآلِهَةً إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا إِنَّ هَذَا لَشَيْءٌ عُجَابٌ. So amazing. This man made all gods to be one God? All gods only one? This is amazing. This what made him. Say, this is too much. How can be only one? What about all this that we have? They have 360 idols on top of the Kaaba. Okay? And each tribe has their own God. Same thing like you found every church, they have their own Bible, they have their own ideology. Some believe that Jesus is God, some they believe that He's Son of God, and some they believe they are three in one, and some they believe that Maria is the God. So those people also, they tribes, big families, and each family they have their own God. Okay? Nevertheless, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also telling us about the nations before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Messenger. The same thing their community object when they came to them. Allah telling us in Surah Zariyat, كَذَلِكَ مَا أَتَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا قَالُوا سَاحِرٌ أَوْ مَجْنُونَ أَتَوَاصَوْا بِهِ بَلْ هُمْ قَوْمٌ طَاغُونَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, what the meaning is, when any messenger came to them before you, they said he's a crazy magician, okay? Indeed, they are a transgressor people, okay? The quality of the mushrikeen, the quality and the description of the mushrikeen, how you recognize them and how you can tell that when Allah Almighty alone mentioned, they disturb. But when Allah and gods mention, now they feel satisfaction. When Tawheed comes, this is disturbing for them. When you start to tell them about all these gods, they happy. Right? So they will reject. And their hearts, they are not in ease. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in Surah Az-Zumur, وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ اشْمَأَزَّتْ قُلُوبُ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ دُونِهِ إِذَا هُمْ يَسْتَبْشِرُونَ. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned, the hearts of those who doesn't believe in the akhirah, in the hereafter, will feel they feel not satisfied.
Okay. Dissatisfaction.
Okay. Anyway. Okay. That's okay. We'll come, inshallah. Okay. Alright? You know what I'll try to, okay?
Yes.
But if the other gods who lesser and nothing beside God are mentioned, they are happy and content. They have a big smile in their face. Okay? And this is the quality. This is the kind of people you can see when you mention these gods, everybody happy and content. But when the Prophet ﷺ telling them Allahu Ahad, Allahu Samad, they are not happy with it. Okay? They are not satisfied. And Allah also describes them how they reject their tawheed. ذَلِكُمْ بِأَنَّهُ إِذَا دُعِيَ اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ كَفَرْتُمْ وَإِنْ يُشْرَكْ بِهِ تُؤْمِنُوا فَالْحُكْمُ لِلَّهِ الْعَلِيِّ الْكَبِيرِ سُورَةُ غَافِرٍ. That because when Allah alone is called upon, you will disbelieve. But when you associate partner beside him, now you believe. So the ruling only belong to Allah, the Most High, All Wise. Although these verses talks about the kuffar, okay? These verses describing and qualifying the kuffar, the mushrikeen. Nevertheless, you'll be surprised that you found this quality applied to some of the Muslims who live in nowadays. Okay? This ayat and these verses, it talks about those kuffar in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But you'll be surprised to see and to notice that some of the Muslims who live in nowadays, that this quality can apply to them. When you call in Allah or teach the people about Allah or give classes about Allah, no one want to come. Nobody understand, have the patience to learn about Allah. Alright? And it's not this only, they start to call the person who teaching Tawheed and the proper Aqeedah and the proper belief about Allah, giving them different titles, different qualities, okay? To scare the people from them, okay? Make different labels for them, okay? He's Mutashaddid, these people extremists, these people are Wahhabi, these people understand, whatever they found names, and the people even doesn't know what these names, they repeating things, okay? Why? Only because the people teaching the proper belief about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of the people, when you say, Ya Allah, okay, they are not happy. But when you say, Ya Muhammad, Ya Hassan, now, okay, Ya Ali, now they like this, because they feel that this like, exactly, like the mushrikeen, that those people have a high spirit, and they can mediate between you and the Allah. So if you say, Ya Allah, so this man is Wahhabi, or this man, you understand, about Aqeedah business, he's about Tawheed, okay, about this, okay? But they do not say it this way. They found always, he is okay.
Maya.
I know what you're going to tell him. But he's going to ruin the whole building and he's not going to find it. It's okay. Inshallah. Okay? But when you start to say, oh Hassan or Hussein, people are so happy. Alright? I remember when I was about 12 years old. Okay? I went there beside the University of Azhar. I was a little kid, maybe about Jay's height, okay? Not his age, but his height. This is a friend of my father. He's a friend of my father, but he's totally two different ways. He's almost like a Sufi, okay? And so he taught me, and we went to visit there. And I saw the people going there around the grave. They're making tawaf as if they go around the Kaaba. And they're jumping up and down and crying and calling, you understand? So I was shocked to see this because this was the first time because we don't go to this stuff. The way how my family raised me, I understand we are not about this. So this is the first time I come to see this with my own eyes. And I was running there, you understand? And the man came running behind me. He was standing talking with somebody. And he ran because he know what I'm going to do. Okay. Although I was a kid.
Were you 12 years old?
Yeah.
So you knew what was happening.
Oh, I know it's wrong. I saw it's a shirk. Mm-hmm. They're calling other than Allah, people prostrating, you understand, to the grave, and people crying, men and women like this, mm-hmm. back to back, okay, and they're going around, okay. Big, huge thing, you understand, almost like a pilgrimage. And the man came running, I understand, and he grabbed me and said, come on, we're leaving from here, okay? So you'll be surprised, you understand, that if people will fight you if you tell them, if you ask Allah, if you seek help, seek from Allah alone. But these people, they don't want to adhere to this, and if they hear you teaching this, they will give you different labels to discourage other people to be part of you. Now we want to give a general idea or a general description, classify some of the scholars, okay? Because the scholars can be any person, okay, does not have to be a person who applying the knowledge. Scholars, that mean he have the knowledge. But some people that, as we stated in the hadith few days ago, like a land. Among the land you have different types. You have rocks, you have sand, you have dirt, you have mixture, okay? Some of them good for fertilized land and agriculture and things like this, and some of them hard.
Different colors.
Exactly, different colors, different types, mm-hmm. all right? So it's not all the land has the same color, and not all the land have the same... Yes, so the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the knowledge that came to me from Allah is like a rain. And when it came down, came on the earth, okay, there is different types of the land. Some of the land, it took the water, absorbed the water, and in return gave green to the people. While others, you understand, was solid or rocks and did not absorb, and the water remains there, make a pool there. And the people came, take the water, and take it someplace else and use it. The third type of land, like sand, it didn't, you understand, give green, it didn't hold the water for the people to use. Okay? This is the worst. Okay? Because one is the best, that it benefit itself and benefit others. The second one, holds the knowledge for, hold the water for us to come, take your cups and your cans and fill it and take it someplace else. Okay? But the third one was nothing. They didn't give it to you and did not give you green back. Okay? So the same thing when you have some scholars, because you have some Yahudi in USC, they give an Islamic course. Okay? And they pass in the Muslim or fail in them. Alright? You get A+ or you flunk the test. So, when we're talking about scholars, we're talking in general. Those people who learn and study and went to university and learn all this deen. But their stand from the Tawheed are different also. of those that the scholars, the true scholars, supposed to be the inheritance or the heirs of the prophets. They inherit the prophets, and they're supposed to be the people who on the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the first thing the Prophet invited the people to is what? The Tawheed, the Aqeedah. The first thing he laid down is the foundation. If you don't have the proper foundation, proper belief in Allah, that Allah as-Samad, الَّذِي لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفْوًا أَحَدْ, that Allah is the one. The one in everything, okay? And He is the master. He's the giver, He's the taker. He has no father, He has no son. He has no equal, no similarity. If you don't have this proper aqidah, okay, it's not going to help your fasting or your prayer. So this is very important. So what the Prophet start with, this is what we need to start with if we are a true scholars. Okay? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had told us in Surah An-Nahl, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ اِعْبُدُوا اللَّهُ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ. This is the mission of all the prophets, all the nations. First class, the first course is Tawheed. Not Islam and politics, Islam about social and social life, and Islam and the women and women. All these things comes later. For Islam and Allah. What Islam say about Allah? What Islam say about the day of judgment? What Islam say about the angels? What Allah is saying about the prophets, the books, the decree? This is your foundation. People make conferences. I've been observing one of these so-called mother organization in America. Okay? For the last 25 years, I read the when they have a conference, they have this list, they call it the agenda. You found everything, and you try it next time when you get to understand any of this big, huge conference, 20,000 people coming there. Talks about economics, talks about politics, you understand this and that. And you don't find one lecture about Tawheed. You understand? About Allah, Allah's names, Allah's qualities, Allah's attributes, understand the message. Everything about everything in Islam. But you can imagine for 25 years, your whole list of lectures did not have one lecture. And you have 20,000 people sitting there. All what you're telling them about, you understand, like giving them a story, something to appetize them, you understand, make them come again, and this is it. So what? So Allah is saying, indeed we have sent in every nation a messenger that worship Allah alone. Single Allah with all your ibadah. And avoid the taghut. And avoid the shaitan. Avoid the shirk. Avoid associating partner beside Allah. This is the foundation of every deen and every message and every book and every prophet and every messenger. Number one, to teach his community is Tawheed. An i'budu Allah, that worship Allah alone. And the taghut, you have to avoid it. A taghut, anything that worship beside Allah or instead of Allah. Beside Allah or instead of Allah. As a result of this, it became the main job and the main mission of all scholars to start with what the Prophet start with. Not to start with giving you tajweed, okay, giving you Islamic history. All these things is good. But if you don't know who's your Lord,
that is zero.
So you're wasting your time.
Yeah.
Okay? And to advise the people to Tawheed in all types of Tawheed. The Tawheed of Rububiyyah, the Tawheed of Uluhiyyah, the Tawheed of Asma and the Sifat. Especially about calling and invoking. How many Muslims, even in Arabia, I'm not talking about America, even in Arabia, Islamic countries, even in the Azhar, beside the Azhar, beside the Azhar, immediately. This was the first Islamic university that had been exist. Okay? Everybody know Azhar. Okay? You'd be shocked. Cross the street right away. They have this mosque called Al-Hussein Mosque. Supposed to be the grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, buried there. Some people they say that he's buried there. Some people say that his head is there. And the surprising thing that in Iran also they have the mosque of Al-Hussein and supposed to have the body of Hussein there.
The same body.
You see?
Two different places.
You see? And doesn't matter if it's there or not there. The people actually making tawaf.
Yes.
So you go around it. They lay down on the dome, on the grave. Mm-hmm. They be crying and weeping.
And whipping.
Asking.
Yeah.
Asking, you understand, yeah. Him to help them in their life. This is a serious shirk. Okay? And after this we will finish time for those. You go make the salah and come back again and say, do the same thing. They don't understand the proper tawheed. They do not understand the proper tawheed. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us, "Ad-du'a huwa al-ibadah." Supplication is the ibadah. So if you don't know who's the one to call on, so that means you're calling on somebody other than Allah, you are associating partner beside Allah. And after this, you go and make your salah. You say, "Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in." What you don't? You don't know what he's saying. You see? Most of the Muslims nowadays, they had fell into shirk. And they call and invoke other than Allah. And this what caused their humiliation. And for them to be defeated. And losing their properties, their lands. This is the kuffar. And they became the worst among all other nations. So the scholars concerning this issue of Tawheed are different. One of them, which is the first category, okay, they understood the Tawheed and the importance of the Tawheed and the types of Tawheed. And they also understood the opposite of Tawheed and the type of Shirk, okay? And they fulfilled their duty. And they clarify this matter to the people. And they supporting what they saying with Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And those are the true scholars. And they've been faced with a lot of hardship and difficulty. Same way the Sunnah of Allah with the prophets. Why the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, people, his people turned to be enemy to him. Only because he told them, "La ilaha illallah. Worship none other than Allah." So those dua, the imams and the leaders who follow the footsteps of the Prophet and they start to teach and they preach the Tawheed, people became enemies. A great number of the people turned to be their enemies. And sometimes even they be fired from their jobs. Fired from being imams in a mosque. Things like this, okay? What did they do? They remained on the path of Tawheed. And they became Hafsabar. Because Allah had told His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Wasbir ala ma yaquluna wahjurhum hajran jameela." Be patient, O Muhammad, with what they say about you and ignore them in a godly way. Keep with your da'wah. Stay busy with what you're doing. Don't pay them any attention. So those dua, the caller to Allah, who calls the people to Tawheed, they went through a lot. And some of them, even their books been abandoned from libraries. Okay? But they did not have anything to do other to follow, the prophets, and especially the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, to remain patient. The wise man Luqman, whom Allah had told us about him in the Quran, he said to his son, Ya bunayya, aqim as-salah, wa'mur bil-ma'roof, wanha 'anil munkar, wasbir 'ala ma asabak, inna dhalika min 'azmi al-umur. O my son, establish the prayer, enjoy the good, and forbid the bad, and be patient with the calamities that fall in you, because this is from the high esteem and the serious determination. Be strong. Okay? Inna dhalika min azmi al-umur. You will have azm, a serious determination. Not because you got fired from the job, okay, because they teach in Tawheed, or they call you Wahhabi, call you Salafi, call you whatever they call. See, brothers, it's too much for me, I could not. Okay? No. You're going to have to stay to your belief, and you have to sacrifice. Doesn't matter what can happen, because this is the way of the prophets. The second types of scholars, how they stand towards or according Tawheed, they neglected the da'wah of Tawheed, which is the foundation of Islam. And they went about invite Muslims to Salah, to Islamic Khilafah, okay? And other things which are related in Islam. But they ignore a serious statement in the Quran, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in Surah Al-An'am, وَلَوْ أَشْرَكُوا لَحَبِطَ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ وَلَوْ أَشْرَكُوا لَحَبِطَ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ If they commit shirk, all whatever they're doing from good deed will be spoiled. So what's the benefit of teaching people about economic in Islam, politics in Islam, social life in Islam, and you don't have Tawheed? Yes, he teaches them about Salah, but he prayed to who? He prayed to Allah, and after this he go calling in other than Allah. So he did not understand, he didn't give him the foundation. How is he going to erect? So you starting to build, but your foundation was a sand. You building on a shore of the ocean. Now as soon as the water hit it, the whole thing will go in the ocean. Okay? So this is the second type of scholars. They focus in their teaching in Islamic knowledge in general, but they had neglected the Tawheed. They did not follow the footsteps of the messenger. And if they did so, they will be successful. Maybe after a while. But the victory of Allah had came to the messengers and those who follow the footsteps of the messengers. Because Allah said in Quran, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ وَلَيُمَكِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمْ الَّذِي طَغَى لَهُمْ وَلَيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا وَمَنْ كَفَرَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. This Surah An-Nur. Allah had promised those who believe among you and do righteous deeds, He made them the inheritance of the earth, as He made others to inherit the earth before them. And He will establish their deen for them, and He will replace them out of their fear, peace and tranquility. Okay? They worship me alone, not to associate any partner beside me. And whosoever disbelieve after this, these are the fasiqun. Those are the outsider. So as long as the people worshiping Allah alone and establish the proper adab of Islam and ibadah, Allah will give them establishment in the earth. But the establishing Salah and this and that and no foundation, they're going to be one day like up, one day down like this. Like you see the Muslims, Ummah, the millions and billions and trillions of Muslims that live in nowadays, most of them, they're making Salah. But why is it been defeated? because they don't have the Tawheed. Because the foundation of victory is the Tawheed. As for the third type of the scholars, they had abandoned the Tawheed. And they abandoned fighting against Shirk because they don't want the people to be rebellious against them. Or they're scared they're going to lose their
leadership
or his position. So they conceal the information. They did not deliver it. And they did not pay attention to the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْتُمُونَ مَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَالْهُدَى مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا بَيَّنَّاهُ لِلنَّاسِ فِي الْكِتَابِ أُولَٰئِكَ يَلْعَنْهُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَلْعَنْهُمُ اللَّاعِنُونَ. Indeed, those who conceal what we have revealed from the guidance, after we made it clear for mankind in the book, Allah curses him and people will curse him. Alright? They say, man, listen, I have three kids, I have to raise my kids. Okay? If I start teaching about Tawheed and this, they think I'm coming from Saudi Arabia or I'm Wahhabi or this and that. No, let me understand, give tarbiyah Islamiyya. Okay? What you do, you understand when you eat, what you eat with the right hand, and wash your hands, and then say Bismillah. And we keep talking about social life in Islam and things like this. And they say, but anything about Tawheed? Nothing. Anything about Shirk? No. Don't talk about it. Okay? Oh, yeah. As for the fourth status, or the fourth types of scholars and da'iyah, those who stand against the Tawheed and oppose the Tawheed. And they oppose that somebody be talking against Shirk or worshipping the awliya and the dead people, that because they see this to be permissible. And they twisted the verses of Allah. And they say these verses only came to the kuffar of Mecca. It has nothing to do with us today. So what? Allah doesn't take anybody's side because they're white or black, they Arab or non-Arab. So the mushrikeen of Mecca, they know that Allah exists, but they worship in Allata, wal-Uzza, Manata, Thalithat, al-Ukhra. They still have all this, but they still know that Allah exists. So the same thing nowadays. People, they make salah to Allah, but after this, Ya Hassan, Ya Hussein, Ya Ali, Ya Ali. What is he saying? Say, Ya Allah. No, these people say, Ya Ali. Okay? Yeah. So how? So that means the Quran came to the people of Mecca, it doesn't apply to... If you're going to act like the people of Mecca, so the Quran is applying to you. Otherwise, you're going to say, oh, the riba was talking about the time of the Prophet, the khamr was talking about the time of the Prophet, everything was related, so we don't have even to pray nowadays.
What are we praying for?
Yeah, see? Yeah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in Surah Al-An'am, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Those who believe, okay, and they did not interrupt or corrupt their faith with any wrongdoing, those are the secure and guided one. So when you corrupted your aqeedah, your belief, with any shirk, you could not have guidance, you could not have safety and security in this life, or in your grave, or in the hereafter. Al-Zulm, what mentioned in this, is the shirk. As Allah said in Surah Luqman, إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. So you explain the Quran by the Quran. Allah says those who did not corrupted their iman with zulm. What kind of zulm? Here Luqman is saying to his son, what? يا بني لا تشرك بالله. Oh my son, don't associate any partner, don't call in anyone other than Allah, because shirk is ظلم عظيم, a great transgression. So you have to have iman pure of any shirk. So whatever the people of Mecca were doing, and the Quran came to disapprove it, if the Muslim doing it today, also the Quran will be applying to them. So the shirk can be applying to the Muslims of nowadays, and even the mu'min of nowadays, as you see it in many Islamic countries. In many Islamic countries, those who allow or approve that the people to call other than Allah, and they allow that the wali and the saint to be buried inside the mosque, and those people who allow that Muslims can go around graves and call in the dead people, and those people who allow people to make a vow and slaughter animal for the dead, okay, and all other innovation and munkarat, the Prophet ﷺ had said in the hadith, إِنَّمَا أَخَافُ عَلَىٰ أُمَّتِي الْأَئِمَّةِ الْمُضُلِّينَ. And this hadith is authentic. The fearful thing for my ummah is a misguided imams. Can be a scholar, but he is misguided. You say, what's wrong? Those people are the good people. They are the awliya of Allah. They are so near to Allah. So what? This is not your business. So try to learn from their history and try to get more close to Allah yourself. He's dead. He could not help you. Even if he's alive. Even if he's alive, what he can do for you? Allah order everybody to pray. Even the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam have to pray. Subhanallah. Say, oh, but they are wali. He's a wali. So why are you burying him inside the mosque? He's a wali. So this term became like a green card, okay? Or credit card. You sweep it in the machine, you can buy. Sweep it and buy. Anything. See, he's a wali. Wali means a saint. That means very holy man, so close to God, okay? But he's dead. Yeah, but you understand? They are alive with Allah. So even if he's alive, where in the Quran Allah say call in the wali? You can predict in Allah saying in Quran, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُ لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُ بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. O Muhammad, when my slave servant ask you concerning me, inform them that I'm near to them. I'm very near. So let them answer my call. And let them believe in me and call on me and call on me and me only. Subhanallah. The people, they don't read the Quran anymore.
Yeah.
And if they read it, they read it already. I understand, but they don't know what. They tend to get a blessing, okay? وَالْقُرْآنَ الْحَكِيمِ إِنَّكَ لَمُرُّ مُرْسَلِينَ عَلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ تَنْزِيلَ الْعَزِيزِ الرَّحِيمِ. Brother, I finished the whole Quran. He did not even finish one verse of the Quran.
5 minutes.
You see? Subhanallah. This is a clear-cut verse in Quran. Why? Oh, because he's near to Allah. But Allah said he's near to you. So that means you're rejecting the Quran. You're rejecting the Quran. You don't believe in what Allah said. You're making your own Islam. You spoiled the whole cake. You didn't follow the recipe. Now you don't have the cake. Okay?
You got mush, you mean?
It's nothing. It's nothing. You take it from the oven and you dump it in the trash. Is this it?
That's mush.
Well, mush, mush. Okay? Yeah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us Ameen. From all this. Ameen. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this hadith is telling us that there is leaders and imams and scholars who are misleading people. And this is exactly what's happening nowadays. Okay? إِنَّمَا أَخَافُ عَلَىٰ أُمَّتِي الْأَئِمَّ الْمُضَلِّينَ. Look to one of this, I was telling you about the Azhar, when somebody asked him the question, and he, Imam, and in Azhar, okay, they said to him, Sheikh, what is the permissibility of making salah in a mosque which has a grave in it? Is it permissible? Look to the logic. He didn't say Quran or Hadith. He said, so what? The Prophet is buried in the mosque in Medina.
Right.
You're going to stop praying, you understand? The Prophet, this was not buried in the mosque. This was the dwelling place of Sayyida Aisha. This when he was buried. Some people, you understand, but now you intentionally go and bury people and making a grave inside the mosque. But let me tell you what is the story behind it. It is nothing except a business. It is a business. Same thing like this Christmas, Halloween, Mother Day, Father Day, Imam Day, Priest Day, all these things. So we can sell more stuff and people buying gift, buying gift, buying gift. So this is the same thing. And I will tell you, inshallah, remind me next week about the story of what you call, not Juha.
The two guys who...
Yeah, but I forgot the term. Inshallah, I will remember. Okay, Sayy and Daya. I tell you the joke or the story of the Sayy and Daya. Okay?
Tell us now. Who got to go to work?
Me.
Huh? Yeah. Who got to go to work?
All right, he insists. Okay. Anyway, so. Okay. Inshallah. Okay. Okay, please, Hassan. Please, Hassan. No. Okay, Hassan, give you $5. Sit down. Okay. So, anyway, it became a business. Now, the people, they bury these things and they bought a box, and all these people, like, 10,000 every week, 10,000 coming, visiting, and dropping money. Dropping money. We stop here, inshallah. Continue next week. Thank you very much. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. And Allah knows best.
How much money, brother?
Too much money.
Too much.
Too much. Millions and millions.
You've been shocked, brother. Especially if you go to India and Pakistan. Yeah.